You put in all this hard work, blood, sweat and tears, and to get to your goal at the end of all of it, you know, it's really rewarding.
Kanah Andrews-Nahu was raising the bar high.
I'd love to make it to bigger and better events, you know, Commonwealth Games, the Olympics, compete with the big girls, big boys.
4 years in the game and 123 records to her name, she's touted as the next big thing in New Zealand weightlifting.
At the moment, she's a record for record breakers. She's genetically gifted, like young Māori Pasifika kids are. They come into any physicality kind of sport and they do really well.
Safe to say, Kanah's experimented with a number of those sports as a kid.
My first sport that I ever did was netball. Then I joined athletics, did some swimming, I did jiu-jitsu.
But it was weightlifting she latched onto, competing in her first comp at just 13, placing second overall and breaking 9 New Zealand records.
Going from only doing 2 days of training a week in other sports to doing a full 5 days at 13, that was quite a lot for me personally. But you know, as you continue, it just becomes routine. And once you build a routine, it's hard to be broken.
That same year, while competing in New Caledonia, she caught the eye of legendary coach Paul Coffer, who recommended she train here at Functional Strength HQ in Auckland under the watchful eye of Comm Games gold medalist Richie Patterson.
Her mindset, she can come in, she works hard, she enjoys what she does, and she takes the good with the bad. So if she has a bad day, she'll leave it at the door and come in tomorrow, positive smile again, and just work just as hard.
He's really shaped me into the lifter that I am. But, you know, he's taught me a lot about how to overcome things. Your body will hands down give up before your mind does. Like, you know, you feel down, but if you think you can do it, you can.
Fast forward to 2018, the sport's taken her around the world. Last year, placing 11th at the IWF Youth World Champs in Thailand and bagging another 4 New Zealand records as well.
You get to see the way they handle themselves. You know, when you see people from other countries, it's a real eye-opener. It's like, wow, you know, we do the same thing, yet they work so differently.
And next month, she'll be voyaging to Argentina for the Youth Olympic Games as the only weightlifter in a 61-strong Kiwi squad.
My main goal is really just to enjoy the experience, but I'd also love to podium. I put on all this hard work so far, so just putting in a little more effort, I'm sure that I could get myself up there enough.
For now, though, she's taking it step by step, with her sights on the ultimate goal of competing in the Olympics and paving the way for other Polynesians to follow suit.
I'd love to inspire other people, you know, from my Pacific heritage, you know, Māori heritage, if they want to participate in these kinds of things, and if I can inspire them to do that, man, that's cool. Everything is so rewarding with this sport, you know, you put in the hard work, you get to where you want to be, and you get the reward. Yeah.